what they would like to present you. Maybe first of all, the team. This conference was organized in cooperation with Teacher College Columbia, New York, and it was endorsed by NCEA. And further on, I would like to thank our cooperation partners for this possibility of this conference. DART, you might wonder why it's DART. DART is the Center of Dialectics of Arts, Textiles and Design. And it's new, and we are the center for this in Austria now, and this is the first kickoff conference. Before we start to present you the team, I would just shortly please ask the team of DART on stage, just that you know who is DART on the homepage. So I would like to ask Barbara Christoph, Alexander, Michaela. Would you please come in front? Yes, please. So just that you know who is DART, that's us. So this is our work. Thank you. Our heartfelt thanks goes first out to our loved ones for their understanding and support throughout this project, because they shared a lot of time we needed for this conference. Next, before we start with the official opening, I would like to say my special thanks. Michaela Götzsch, she was my assistant in the project. Yes, please come here. Without her, I would not have managed this, and you had all the correspondence. This was Michaela, so please give a big applause to Michaela. Schmidt. Without her, we would not have this happen here, and also we would have, you would not see the book. Of course, you dedicated a lot of work for the book and for the conference, but I would like to ask Anja on stage, please. If Christian Schneider would not be here with his team, we also would have big problems, because he is managing everything that this works here. We have the exhibition, and we have the conference hall. So thank you very much for coming. Please come here. I would like to thank very much Eva Maria Stadler. Please. She was our curator. Posch, I don't know if he's here now, but he also supported us. Further on, I want to say Daniel Aschranken and Conny, they will present afterwards a performance, but I would like to on stage and thank you. Thank you. Now just a short situation. There are many people behind. You might not recognize, but you will need throughout these days that you know who is helping you, the little helping hands, but they are working since many, many hours. So first of all, I want to ask Benedikt. Thank you. Milena on stage, please. Milena, on stage, please. Yes, Milena. Then I would like to ask Angelika. Angelika? Stefan? Yeah, Angelika is here. Of course she's here.
Thank you very much.
Then we have Stefan and Stefanie. Are we here now? No. Zorro? Der Heidi. Alex? Gabriela? Yes, he's here.
Zorro. Yes.
So, all of them will help you when you have any problems. Then you'd like to ask Sale on stage?
No, Sale is not here.
Sale is not here? No, sorry. But I forgot Sale. No? Okay, I want also to thank Yasmin very much. Yasmin, without you and helping him, we would have also big problems. Thank you very much for your help. Yes, and I want to ask also to thank our camera team, Käse and Sascha Osaka for the photography. And further on, I would like to say my special thanks to all the chairs who you will meet tomorrow and to all extra work everybody does. And maybe if I forgot any name, I would like to thank everybody I would not have mentioned now. Now I would like to give the introduction to our president. Such a conference would never take place if you don't have such a marvelous and generous president as we have, who is fighting for art education in Austria and abroad. And I would like to give you the stage to give your entrance speech.
Thank you, Ruth. Well, now it's my role to thank you. You really need an applause, a big applause. I am convinced about the importance and necessity of art education in our 21st century societies, and that I'm therefore fighting for that. But it's not possible to fight alone. We have a marvelous team at the University of Applied Arts who go in the same direction. Barbara, Christoph, a lot of teaching staff, and not the least the students, they all are convinced that they are going to do a big and important job, and they are convinced that this is a field we really need in our societies, and therefore it's necessary to focus on art education. And therefore I'm really grateful and proud that this conference is taking place in the next few days. And I also have to say that I'm proud, and maybe you as well, Richard, a little bit. I really remember some 2 years ago when we met, or even more, in New York at your new home, I can say. When we talked about what could we do together, Teachers College of Columbia University and the University of Applied Art, and we found we should start this kind of conversation, open conversation, on the role of art, art education in our societies. And looking what happened last year in New York and looking at the program of the next 2 days here, I really can say it's a success story, and we should continue that. Thank you all for coming. Thank you all who participated in this effort. And let's go on, enjoy the evening and enjoy the next 2 days and get home again very much inspired in the role of what we are doing here and in the importance of what we are doing. Thank you.
So, ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues and friends, I now have the pleasure of welcoming you, also from my side, to the opening of our symposium. Somehow to be the bridge from tonight to the symposium tomorrow. A symposium that I'm sure will provide a great opportunity for exchange, and in which we will be concerned with conducting a situation appraisal in the field of art education. We will question and seek to deepen our understanding of various ways of viewing the practice of art education, and not least, with the future in mind, we will attempt to determine just what can be said about potentials of an advanced form of teaching of art and about the task it implies. The past 15 years or so have seen the coming into being of a wide range of points of intersection between art and pedagogy, marked by the catchphrase educational turn. While on the one hand, Europe's educational systems have undergoing serious modifications as a result of processes of regulation and standardization, on the other hand, during the same period, education and pedagogical issues have been the subject of intense debate. This orientation of focus towards the pedagogical has been directly linked to criticism of the economization of education that we have clearly been witnessing. A great number of self-organized forums have evolved both outside and inside institutions. Forums that advocate education as being, and here I allow myself to quote Irit Rogov, the site of a coming together of the odd and unexpected, and of shared curiosities, shared subjectivities, shared sufferings, and shared passions, all of which congregate around the promise of a subject, an insight, a creative possibility. Ideally, education creates collectives, collectivities, many fleeting collectivities, as Robert puts it in her essay entitled Turning. Education, she says, signals rich possibilities of coming together and participating in an arena not yet signaled. Robert sees education as thus being able to release energies, enabling us to progress from what can be opposed to what can be imagined. On the other hand, politically driven developments in the field of institutionalized production of knowledge, especially those of the past 15 years, have taken place under the heavy sway of the dispositive of efficacy. As a result, those open spaces that should foster development are being reduced and suppressed. Spaces that considered holistically are so essential to society's awareness of the important, urgent issues of today and tomorrow. Spaces that are essential to society's very ability to deal with the problems. These are spaces that possibly could open up entirely new perspectives. Under the constant pressure to conform, educational institutions such as art schools wear themselves out struggling to keep providing those open, generous structures, that room for thought, that room for maneuver, room for action and for freedom, which is prerequisite for what Irit Rogov sees as being essential to structuring education for, with, and through the arts, namely potentiality. For Rogov, potentiality inhabits the realm of the possible without prescribing it as a plan. She urges us to think of this potentiality as being, in her words, at the very center of acts of thinking, making, and doing. She urges us to think of it as being at the heart of the academy, whose particular quality she sees not in the constant demands for substantiation, but rather in moments of speculation, moments in which the eyes is open wide, moments of broadening, moments of experimentation, discovery, and reflections. However, as before, the quality of academies, of art schools, continues to manifest itself in the steadiest determination to provide and safeguard open spaces in which circumstances can be interpreted and learned from the unconventional ways, as well as spaces that encourage bold steps and leave room for open-ended processes in which no one is expected to know in advance where thought and practice are to lead. The goal is to create within the study framework a space for learning and for development that provides impulses to thought processes and working methods which are not automatically adapted to knowledge that has been transmitted or to practice that have been established without questioning. And this means opening up spaces for thought and action where differences and disagreement are welcome. Therefore, I come to an end. Therefore, of central importance, here are not those learning processes that increase knowledge on the basis of set requisites for learning schemata, but rather learning processes that transform these basic requisites. Art schools maintain spaces that are consciously structured to ensure that encounter and debate regularly take place. Art classes are spaces in which individuals with their experience show themselves and recognize themselves as being distinct. Spaces in which meaning and value emerge through a mutual exchange, through the recognition and creation of relationships, interconnections, affinities within groups and networks. In these provocative communities, to use a term coined by Jan Ferwerth, experience and knowledge can be understood as forms of social relations. It is imperative that all of us do what we can to keep these spaces for learning, development, encounter, and action alive and open. It will indeed be worth taking the time to discuss how each of us conceives of the notion, a good way of living, and the visions that motivate us in order to bring these into sharper focus and give utopia some room. So the next 2 days will be an opportunity for us to exchange ideas about theory, practice, realities, and visions, and an opportunity to probe these ideas and discuss them. I am delighted at the prospect of an open and productive process of debate, and this chance we have to get to know each other better by discussing what truly motivates us. And beyond that, special thanks to all our colleagues who brought an art piece to this exhibition in the other room. That thank you for not only contributing to the conference as speakers, but also sharing with us your artistic approach. So to all of you then, a warmly welcome. Thank you very much.
We are here united. A lot of people, many students from Austria, people from Belgium, people from Czechoslovakia, from Switzerland, from Israel, from Turkey, Serbia, Hungary, Spain, and Japan. And maybe some other countries we don't know yet. Thanks for coming. And I also want to welcome two of my art students also made it here and their parents. Thank you for coming. And now I would like to ask Richard Jochum, our colleague from Columbia, New York, to say a few words about the collaboration, and then maybe overtake it to Eva Maria.
Thank you. Good evening. Thank you very much, Ruth, and your team for this wonderful collaboration and putting this all together. Thank you also, Gerard Bast, for striking up this partnership. It's wonderful to see how something then comes to life after a year of working together. Last year we did this symposium and exhibition in New York, and now it's happening here. That's wonderful. I want to also thank my colleague and program director, Judy Burton, for the support and her vision, in which I find a great home. That means the brief that is part of my job to create spaces to look at how we teach and learn art in universities as well as in schools is a the opportunity that actually was at the beginning of this collaboration. And it's great to see quite a few colleagues from America coming here, and I heard from many other countries. That's quite astounding thing, because it's not easy to travel through space, and we do it because we have an ambition, we have a motivation, and we believe in the conversation. The original kind of putting together of the symposium was very much actually driven by the idea of conversation, to create a space for conversation and keep the institution a little, and the institutional dialogue a little lower, but kind of letting really us all as practitioners share our experience and talk about what really matters in our practice. And that happened, I think, in really nice ways in the symposium that we had in New York. And now, knowing that the format and lots of its pieces were taken to now bring, yeah, I mean, they shaped the form it took that Ruth prepared for us here. I'm very curious how this will unfold, and I'm looking forward to the conversation. Some of the pieces, of course, when people collaborate across spaces and the internet and the telephone, etc., happen to get lost in translation. The original brief that we had, and that let me talk a little bit about the exhibition, was to create an exhibition around works of art that are created by artists who teach and who work with their students, whether it's a community or their students in a university setting, collaboratively. To work collaboratively is an interesting thing, because it's not easy. Often artists are a little helpless about how do I bring in the students into the work, and where it really merges, and not just the student becomes a helper, an assistant, but where the piece is carried by the authorship of collaboration. That was the original idea, and some of the pieces in the exhibition are, I think, come from that spirit. A few others show a different angle, and that's also wonderful, because as we lose certain things in translation, other things come into play. I'm looking forward to that, and thank you very much, and I'm looking forward to the symposium. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Maybe it wasn't because I was too nervous. Forget me, but a very warm welcome to the to all our people from the United States, of course, because this is because of our collaboration. Many applied to come here. Thank you very much for coming. I would now like to ask Eva Maria Stadler to say a few words about the exhibition, and then we will have the performance, and then we have to get together, and we'll go on.
Yeah, thank you, Ruth. Yeah, it was a very interesting situation when Ruth asked me to help her to work on this small presentation within the conference. Because the conditions of doing an exhibition like this are very special, because the conditions came out of the communication of the conference at the Columbia University, and it was like a project in between the project in New York and the project here in Vienna. And so we were talking about and had different ideas how we could make these things visible. So these ideas should also be part of the exhibition. So there are seven artists which brought very interesting pieces to show them here in Vienna, and they are coming from very different angles concerning the works. Like, we have different medias, but also the contents, of course, are very different. So what we try to do now is to give the whole thing a common context within a platform, and this platform, the measurements of the platform, is also has a relation to this building and has a relation to the regulations of fire police, because there has to be an exact measurement what's the distance to the wall, and so you can imagine how this platform is formed by this regulation. And so it is also the pieces we do see are also depending on regulations like this. And therefore I want to also to thank the artists, because they all were open and participated in the process where they had to say, okay, I'm ready to go for that, to show my piece in this situation, and not to take a single space from my work, a single plinth or whatever, a single frame. And because what we were suggesting is to build this kind of platform, because it's kind of a stage. Yves Lambois, the French art historian, is talking about horizontality as a state of being. And I think this is an interesting term to think about working. And to work, to discuss, to collaborate, I think it was said today already sometimes, and maybe it will be also an important theme in the next days, is of course a very important part in art and art education. And so we took this kind of stage as a sign, maybe for this cooperation. Yeah, I want to thank Monika van Kooijen. She has really done a really great job with her video. You can see it there, because this video needs normally a very special kind of cinematic situation. So we found a solution to build this up. It's a video and telling as showing a woman in a very specific state of being contemplative, but also discursive, and so it brings up a certain mood, I would say, in this exhibition. Yes, you will see also a very interesting project of Ruth. She did it with Liliana Narvic, you know. And they were working with kids in the school, and they tried to bring together different disciplines like mathematics and the arts. And we have a kind of a pile of posters which were done by kids when they were working on producing tiles, and they also had to construct them in a mathematical sense, but they were also learning on the background of like the patterns and like the labyrinth or things like that from the point of art history. And I think this is an interesting approach you did to bring the posters or to bring the work of the kids into this representation. And so there was also another work of Osko Soganci, and he is showing a collage and where he's referring to a poem of Gareth Evans. And he's also trying to make a poetic reference to this work of pupils together, and I think so it's maybe a nice connection between these two works. And also in this sense I would read the work of Richard Jochum, and he's showing a work where we made kind of a little documentation with a poster and the book and a sound file about the blanket project. And it's a kind of tale which is referring to kids using a blanket, and they have to communicate to share this blanket. And you used this kind of project to communicate in a broader context, I would say, when it's correct. Then we have a very interesting sculpture of Larven. And this, what happens here in a very nice way is when we have a sculpture like this together with the video of Caterina Diazzolde, an Italian artist, and Eduardo Benamor Duarte, because you can see it, the two artists made this video out of an installation where they were working with sculpture and choreography, and they are coming together very different ways of expression, and so I think that's a very nice communication between these two works. Yeah, and then we have Augusto Zubiaga. Here he did today a very interesting installation where he is kind of binding the whole thing together via neurons, and you can really touch a kind of a pad, and through this to touching there comes some energy to kind of light, comes out, that brings up the light of the neurons. And I think so this is this kind of bringing up the sensitivity is maybe also could be a motto for the next days, that this is a very, very important attitude, I would say, we all could need for our work. So thank you very much for your patience, and have fun with the exhibition.
Thank you very much. The exhibition will be afterwards, you can see it in the room on the left side. Just to give you a short overview, this conference was double-blind peer-reviewed. This is the highest state of scientific approach international. So two reviewers would look at your papers without knowing each other. And then we had other editors. One of our main editors, Gretchen Mason, we had in a very short time announce this conference, we had 34 applications for papers, and we have 28 presenters and 4 workshops and an exhibition. And what we did, we did not do a proceeding. Many conferences have proceedings, so everything is published. Our idea was to make a book where, yes please, show it, where Michaela and I edited it. Thank you, Roger. So this is the book we did. So this was selected papers. It was not easy. We got a lot of feedback. This is not very, we're not used to it actually in Austria so much, to get editing for papers. It's not our native language, so it's quite challenging for us. But we tried to do our best, and you can, tonight, you can also buy this book to a special price. It will be for 18 euro. You can get it over there. From our helpers. Yes, and the graphic design, yeah, exactly. So the graphic design was made by Pierre Schaller and Gerhard Jordan. They are two alumni from our university, so we always try to collaborate with our students or alumni. And now I would like to ask Barbara to introduce the performance and give a few words on Daniel and Colin.
Yeah, please allow me to introduce to you now my estimated colleagues, the performing artist Daniel Ashwanti and the media artist Colin Zeng, who will perform for us tonight. Daniel experiments with transdisciplinary methods in urban contexts, departing from body-related agendas, applying a choreographic gaze to urban surroundings. His works articulate themselves in a wide range of formats, reaching from interventions in public spaces to installations and performances in gallery spaces and theaters. and relating social and art agendas. Connie is a media artist focusing on generative video art, installation and performance. And they recently collaborated in a performance with colleagues in the Tanzquartier and the museum's quarters called Bastard Crowding and Selfie Looping. So this is related to what you see tonight, which is an artistic reflection of our extensive use of communication devices, especially smartphones, as you can see, and addresses topics like surveillance or quantification and the production of selfies as a self-related practice, as well as the integration into an anonymous mass. Thank you.
together, get to know each other, have a drink of wine, look at the exhibition, and tomorrow we will meet on the conference at 8 o'clock, yes, very early. So we have a lot of a big program, so we need to start early. And I wish you a very nice evening. Thank you.